Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good afternoon everyone. Good afternoon. For me myself. How are you everyone? Everything good?
Fine, sure. Thank you.
Alhamdulillah. Okay, good. Okay guys, before we start the class, I think, as usual, I have to call your name one by one. But before that, let's pray Sidua first, okay? Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Atau Abigan. Okay, I'll start from TI, yeah? Ahmad Dedi Khairunas. Ahmad Dedi, are you there?
Present, sir.
All right. Good. Next one. I'll call this nothing. And Arif Kurniawan.
Arif Kurniawan still on the way, sir, from Jakarta.
On the way.
Yes.
But he joined the class, right?
Yes.
He joined the class, right? He joined the Zoom or not?
Join, sir.
Join, sir.
Okay. No? He's not joined?
He's joined, sir.
Oh, he's joined. Good, good, good. Next one, Dani. It's Marian Toruhian.
Dani is Bangkit Program, sir.
Bangkit Program.
Yes.
Right.
It is a sensor, sorry.
Okay. Faisal Tanjung Nati, Febriado Prasetyana.
Present, sir.
Okay. Siapa? What's your name?
Febriando Prasetyo, sir.
Febriando Prasetyo. Okay.
Yes.
Thanks, thank you. Yuhari Kurniawan?
Present, sir.
Okay. And then... Yuhari Kurniawan. Ferdinand Rizky Budianto. Ferdinand Rizky Budianto. Budiarto.
Ferdinand on the way, sir.
On the way.
Yeah.
Ferdinand on the way. Next one. Gufran Amri. Gufran Amri, nothing, ya? Yeah.
Nothing, nothing. From one semester.
From semester one.
Yes.
From semester, okay. Next one, Muhammad Saifuddin Tamami.
Present, sir.
Okay. Michelle Muhammad Mikael Kartawijaya nantinya.
Nothing.
Yeah. Muhammad Tufatur Razikin. Tufatur Razikin?
Present, sir.
Alright. And the next one, Ovita Sri Damayanti.
Present, sir.
Alright. Ahmad Siddiq.
Present, sir.
Oke, Ramadian. Kan Ramadian Jadia Dwi Putra. Ramadian, there are you here? Is there any information from Ramadian? Nothing, Ramadian?
Nothing, sir.
Oke. Rasmatian, zero. Next one. Reni, nothing. Rian Ardiansa, nothing. Rifki Alansah.
Rifki Alamsa present, sir.
Alright. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Yo, welcome. Rinanto, katama Adi Prayoga.
Present, sir.
Alright. Don't worry, don't nothing. Okay, good. We go to the next probably. Next class, which is from SC, Sistem Informasi. Abi Sopian Sauli.
Present, sir.
Okay. Next, Afrizal Adi Putra. Bangkit Program, benar. Now. Nothing. Go. Arya Davin. Arya Davin.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next. Dwi Aji Pangestu. Dwi Aji Pangestu. Anyone know Dwi Aji Aji? Dwi Aji Pangestu. Dwi Aji Pangestu, nothing. Nothing ya, Mas Arya? Hello. Nice. Handoko Dani Abdul Majid. Handoko Dani Abdul Majid. Nothing. Okay. Iwan.
Present, sir. Present, sir.
Okay, then.
Thanks, sir.
Yo. Next one. Satria Tribowo, nothing. Okay. We go to last but not least, which is from EF, Informatika. Bagas Aditya Pratama.
Present, sir.
Okay. Bintang Aditya Abiyasalam. Are you there? Nothing. Fauzan Hibatullah, nothing. Irfan Maulana.
Present, sir.
Okay.
Irfan present, okay. Sir.
Irfan present, I know. Irfan Maulana, right?
Yes.
Rehan Al-Ghifari.
Present, sir.
Okay. Next one, Maher Zainuddin Mukti Umar, nothing. Muhammad Khairi, nothing. Muhammad Rizik Susanto.
Present, sir.
Okay. Muhammad Zain Zufar, nothing. Mukhtar Khairunisa, nothing. Nurul Burhan, nothing. Arif Prabowo Sulistyo, nothing. Renaldi Bagas Pangestu.
Present, sir.
Okay. And then Reza Dewa Mahesa, nothing ya. Okay. Usama Putra Andita. Usama Putra Andita. Okay. Yogi Christopher Sumuli, nothing. Alright. Handoko Dani. Mas Handoko, what prodi or SC? SE Handoko. Mm. Alright. Okay, can you see my slide, everyone? Can you see it? Okay, is it clear? Does it clear or not my screen, everyone?
Yes, sir.
All right. Okay, please, we're going to talk about writing tracks. Yeah? Writing tracks. Do you know these tracks? Do you know tracks, right? Track. This track. Tracks. Jebakan. So we have to be careful with the writing tracks. Okay, let's see. Next one. This is the outline for the writing track. There is plurals and possessive and capitalizations. Yeah. Plurals is jama, possessive is kepemilikan, capitalization is how to capitalize the word. Okay. For the objective is there are two objective formula, punctuate singular and plural possessive correctly. We know the objective is you have two. No, or you I hope you can punctuate singular and plural possessive correctly, and also I hope you can apply the capitalization rules in correspondence. That's the objective for our meeting. For the first one that we have to know, or we have to learn, is about the non-assertion. Yeah, non-assertion, non sebagai kepemilikan. Non and pronoun can show possessions or ownership. Yeah, jadi non atau pronoun dan pronoun itu dapat menunjukkan kepemilikan atau ownership itu sendiri of other non. Terkait dari kata benda yang lain. At times, it can be tricky to identify possessive because of nouns, such as a value or belief or hope, seperti nilai percayaan atau harapan, are abstract, mereka itu abstract. In other words, they are not concerned object, mereka itu bukan objek. Let's see. The easiest way to determine whether a word is a noun is to place the word in front. Is to place the word the in front of it. Nah, jadi cara yang gampang untuk menentukan kata sebuah kata itu adalah noun is to place the word the. Kita menempatkan kata sebuah kata the, ya, the. In front of it, ya, di depannya. If the phrase sounds complete, the word is probably no. Alright. For example, everyone. A train, my voice is a train, really. Maybe your sign on us. What about the others? Do you hear my voice is a train? Or not?
Yes, sir.
You can wait. I will try. What about now?
Better, sir.
Better.
Better.
Better, sir?
Yes, yes, better.
All right. The easiest way to determine whether a word is a noun, yaitu untuk cara gampangnya untuk menentukan apakah kata tersebut adalah noun, is to place the word in front of it. Kita menempatkan the word the, kata the, T-H-E, itu in front of it, di depannya. Di depan noun yang menurut kita itu adalah noun. If the present sounds complete, kalau frasa tersebut, kalau kita sudah tempatkan the di depannya, dan frasanya itu terdengar complete, ya, sempurna, the word is probably a noun. Yang maka mungkin kata tersebut adalah sebuah kata benda. For example, the word idea, the idea, the tune, the color, the glare. This a noun, yeah. The idea, the tone, the color, the glare. That's a noun. Okay, we put the in front of. When two nouns appear together, even when the first noun doesn't end in an S, check to see if the first noun possesses the second one. Ketika ada dua noun appear together, muncul bersamaan, even when the first noun doesn't end in an S, walaupun nounnya itu, noun yang pertama itu tidak diakhiri dengan S, check to see if the first noun possesses the second one. Maka kita cek dulu apakah noun yang pertama itu memiliki sifat kepemilikan enggak kepada noun yang kedua. Yeah. If the first noun possesses the second one, that's a noun. That may have been inadvertently lack of the first noun. Does the first noun need apostrophe and S to show the possession? Apakah noun yang pertama membutuhkan apostrophe atau S untuk menunjukkan possession? Example. Bob's incorrect. This is the example of incorrect noun. Bob's arrival, the windows display the room's color matches hope. Bob's arrival, the windows display the room's color matches hope. Correct. Bob's arrival, the windows display the room's color matches hopes. Like this. Next one, singular nouns not ending in S. Singular nouns not ending in S. Ya, singular noun, noun singular yang tidak diakhiri dengan S. To form the possessive of singular noun that doesn't end in S. Ya, jadi untuk menunjukkan kepemilikan sebuah singular noun itu, dia tidak diakhiri dengan S. Add apostrophe and S. This category is the easiest because you are taking a noun and adding to it in logical way. Here are some examples. This is singular noun, there is singular possessive. Okay. Kalau singular noun itu tidak diakhiri dengan ending S atau apostrophe, ya. So, book, ya, kalau singular possessive, ya kita akhiri dengan kalau dia punya kepemilikan, ya, books cover, and cover is noun, books is also noun. Books cover, so we put the apostrophe and S after the word noun. That's singular noun possessive, and this is singular noun, only singular noun. Book and manager, manager's responsibilities. Okay, that. But sometimes it is difficult to determine whether a noun is truly a possession. Nah, jadi kadang kita agak sulit untuk menentukan whether a noun is showing a possession, menunjukkan kepemilikan. This is especially true within animate objects such as wine, wind, or paper. When in doubt, ask yourself if you can change this.
Putus ya.
I'm sorry, sir. I can hear your voice, sir.
Astaga, astagfirullah. So sorry everyone. Dari tadi saya ngomong enggak saya nyalain mic-nya and no one remind me. I talk by myself for about 15 minutes, right? Oh my god. Please remind me everyone, ya. Yeah? Sorry, thank you. All right. Okay, I repeat again. Singular noun in S, ya. Jadi singular noun, noun yang singular, noun yang singular yang diakhiri dengan S. Shape of sentences, apostrophe plus S. That's the point. The witness, after the witness, there is S over there. Yeah, after the witness, the word witness, I will put the apostrophe and S. Yeah. Answer. The witness answer. Dallas, don't worry. If the addition of an extra syllable would make the word challenging to pronounce, add only the apostrophe as in the following. Ya, kalau if the addition of an extra syllable, kalau kita tambah lagi, extra syllable-nya kita tambah lagi, atau S-nya kita tambah lagi, would make the word challenging to pronounce. Ya, ya. Maka kita cukup taruh apostrophe, ya. We only put the, we enough to put the apostrophe over there. Okay, as in the following. You can see over there. Mr. Jones or Mr. Jonas. Mr. Jonas. Jonas. It's difficult to pronounce, right? So we just put Mr. Jones, not Jonas. Mr. Jones meeting. Like that. Okay. Next one. Mark Phillips. Mark Phillips briefcase. Okay, next. As the noun, singular noun possessive, we put an S or we don't put an S. An apostrophe. And next one, plural possessive. Regular plural possessive form the possessive of regular plural noun. A plural noun ending in S or ES. So add an apostrophe after the S. Kita masukkan apostrophe setelah S itu. In other words, make the singular form of the noun plural before you make the noun possessive. Kata lainnya, kita buat singular form, bentuk singularnya daripada noun menjadi plural before you make the noun possessive, sebelum kalian membuat menjadi noun possessive. Jadi dari singular kita buat dulu menjadi noun plural, habis itu baru kita buat menjadi noun possessive. Let's see. Ya. Can you see the difference between singular possessive and plural possessive, everyone? You can see, right? If singular possessive, the apostrophe after R or before S. Yeah. If the plural possessive, the apostrophe, we put the S after the R and we put the apostrophe after the S, right? The owner's address and that's the owner's address, that's for singular possessive, and for the plural possessive we put the s after r and we put the apostrophe after the s, so become a view owner's addresses. Okay, that's plural possessive. That's the difference between plural singular, non-plural, and non-possessive plural. Next one. Can see for next one. Our manager's decision, all of the manager's decision, that's the form is almost same. Yeah, that's same for the first one and the second one. Employees question, many employees questions. Employees question, many employees question. Yeah, remember the form, yeah. Remember the form of plural possessive. The first one, make the singular form of the noun become plural before you make the noun become possessive. Yeah. Dari owners become, dari owner aja, become owners. Yeah. Become owners. Yeah. Owners become owners. Managers become managers. Employees become employees. Right. Next one. When the singular form of noun already ends in S, ketika singular form itu, bentuk singularnya daripada noun itu sudah diakhiri dengan S, make the noun plural by adding AS, ES, ya. Maka kita buat noun plural dengan menambah AS to the singular pada form singularnya. Then form the possessive by adding an apostrophe. Jadi kemudian kita buat menjadi untuk membuat kita buat menjadi possessive atau kepemilikan dan kita tambah apostrophe. For example, singular business become businesses. Singular possessive-nya business owner. Become plural possessive-nya become businesses owners. Virus become viruses. For the singular possessive-nya become virus organizations, viruses organization. For the plural possessive become viruses organizations. Get it, everyone? Get it? Next one. Some nouns come in mass and are considered non-count nouns. Yeah. Beberapa nouns itu disebut dengan non-count nouns, jadi tidak dapat dihitung. Example include pain or kick or foot. Ya. Terus contohnya seperti chat, pain, cake, ya, or foot. Other example of non-count nouns are honors, integrity, and humor. Okay. Singular possessive for them, a boy scores honor. Several boys scores honor. A person's integrity, many persons' integrity, that's for the non-count noun. Next one, irregular plural possessive. Jadi ada plural possessive yang tidak beraturan. To form the possessive of irregular plural noun, change the singular form of the noun to the plural form and then add an apostrophe and s. To form the possessive of an irregular plural noun, ya, untuk kita membuat possessive, membentuk possessive dalam irregular plural noun, dalam non plural yang tidak beraturan, change the singular form of the noun to the plural form. Kita rubah dia dari singular formnya, nounnya, menjadi plural form, ya. Then add an apostrophe and s. Kita tambah apostrophe dan juga s. Singular possessive. Nah, child for the singular, ya. Child for the plural, children. Yeah. That's irregular. A child's toy become the children's toy. One woman's hat, many woman's hat. One man's idea, many men's ideas. A lady's suggestion become several ladies. Suggestion. Next one, group words, ya. Kelompok dari beberapa kata. With group words or compound nouns, ya. Group words atau compound nouns, the apostrophe and the s are added to the last term. Dan maka apostrophe-nya dan juga s-nya kita tambahkan di bagian akhir. For example. The Queen of England's Duchess, the Queen of England Duchess, England's Duchess, jadi Queen of England's. Tugas daripada Ratu, ya, England, the Attorney General's job. Jadi di the last terms-nya. Her mother's in-laws addresses. Next group of words, ya. Next nouns in series. When the two nouns joined by and share joint possessions, ketika ada dua nouns yang bersamaan, ada berbarengan, and share joint possessions, dan mereka menunjukkan kepemilikan yang sama, add the apostrophe only to the last noun. Ya, jadi kita hanya menambahkan apostrophe-nya pada noun yang terakhir. When there is individual possession, add the apostrophe to both noun. Tapi ketika dia menunjukkan possession secara masing-masing, maka kita we put the apostrophe in both noun, to both noun. Kita taruh apostrophe di setiap noun itu sendiri, kedua noun situ. For example here, for joint ownership, individual ownership. Mitch and Helen's mothers. Kalau Mitch and Helen's mother itu artinya ibunya Mitch dan Helen. Satu ibu berarti. Artinya ibu, satu ibu. Kalau Mitch and Helen's cars atau Mitch and Helen's cars artinya car-nya itu ada banyak. Kayak gitu ya. Menunjukkan kepemilikan masing-masing mempunyai mobil. Mitch car and Helen's car. So there is two cars for here for joint ownership. Mitch and Helen's mother. Mitch and Helen's mother. So the mother of Mitch is same with mother of Helen's joint ownership. Next one, Margaret and Bill's project. Ya, mereka projectnya sama. Margaret and Bill's project, mereka mempunyai project masing-masing. Ya. And the next one, abbreviation. To make an abbreviation plural, simply add an S. For example, abbreviation itu singkatan ya. Three DVDs, blue, green, and yellow, M and M, S. Yeah. Three DVDs, we put the S after. Yeah. DVD become DVDs. Blue, green, yellow, M and M's. Five VCRs. 10 series. So to make an abbreviation possessive, add an apostrophe and s gitu. Untuk menunjukkan kepemilikan terhadap kata singkatan, possess, add an apostrophe and s. Kita taruh apostrophe dan juga s. Ya. Just as you would with regular possessive. Ketika kalian mau menunjukkan menggunakan regular possessive nouns, ya. Example. Abby's new case or the ADA's guidelines for dental hygiene. CNN's reporters, the NBA's new season. And the next one, possessive standing alone, ya. At times, everyone, writer or speakers will make a comparison between two nouns that are showing possession, but leave off the item being possessed after the second noun. Yeah. Be careful in this construction as the second noun also shows possession. Yeah. Ada satu waktu, a writer, seorang penulis atau seorang pembicara akan membuat perbandingan between two nouns. Yeah. Di antara dua nouns that are showing possession, yang menunjukkan kepemilikan, but leave off the items being possessed. Tapi mereka meninggalkan item yang menunjukkan kepemilikan after the second noun, setelah noun yang terakhir. Be careful in this construction as the second noun also shows possession. Kita juga harus hati-hati, ya. Yeah. The traps, this is the traps. Ya, harus hati-hati construction ini. Bisa juga second yang non yang terakhir juga menunjukkan possessions juga, menunjukkan kepemilikan juga. For example, Bob's remark was similar to George. Yeah. Bob's remarks were similar to George. Sometimes they leave off the item being possessed. Yeah. biasanya they usually write or they usually speak. Bob's remark was similar to George, yeah. Without apostrophe and s after, yeah. Yeah, they leave off the item being possessed. So the correct one is like this one, like you can see in the example here. Bob's remark was similar to George's. To George, yeah. Next one, we will meet in Alex's office, not Miko's. Yeah. If you say we will meet in Alex's office, not Miko, without apostrophe and s, so that's wrong. Yeah. Kalau bahasa Indonesia-nya, kita akan bertemu di kantornya Alex, bukan di Miko. Bukan Miko, it's not clear enough. Yeah. So we have to construct as the second and also source possessions. Yeah. So not Miko's office, not Miko's. Maka artinya dia akan bertemu di kantornya Alex, bukan di kantornya Miko. Okay. For example here, Michelle is working on her master's. Michelle is working on her master's, yeah, like that. Okay. Next one, that's for the possessive standing alone, yeah, possessive standing alone. Next one, capitalizations. Capitalization creates special problems for writers, yeah, dalam membuat capitalize the word, yeah, sometimes makes problem for the writer, yeah, memberikan problem pada beberapa penulis. When writer feel unsure about capitalization, they sometimes write everything in lowercase. Ketika penulis tuh kadang merasa tidak yakin untuk membuat capitalize, untuk mengcapitalize sebuah kata, ya. Mereka kadang write everything in lowercase. Mereka menulisnya dalam tulisan kecil semua. This practice is especially true in e-communication. Jadi juga ini bisa kita buktikan di dalam e-communication juga. Other times, writers seems to capitalize word randomly, possibly thinking that common nouns are actually proper noun. Yeah. For professional writing, follow the standard rules of capitalization so that your writing has credibility. Maka untuk seorang penulis profesional, you have to follow the standard rule of how to capitalize the word, when we have to capitalize the word. Yeah. Yeah, so we have to follow the standard rules of capitalization, standard rules of writing in formal writing. Yeah, so your writing has credibility. Yeah. Next one, proper noun and common nouns. Yeah. Before you work on individual rules of capitalization, the most basic place to start is identifying the difference between common noun and proper noun. Yeah. Dalam kita bekerja dalam menentukan individual rules of capitalization, the most basic place, ya, standarnya kita harus mengidentifikasi terlebih dahulu the difference between common nouns. Ya. Apa sih perbedaan common noun dan proper noun? Nah, proper noun is the official name of particular person, place, or thing. Ya, yeah. Proper noun itu officialnya nama resmi dari seorang, tempat, atau benda. Common noun is general term that refers to class of thing. Ya, yeah. Kalau common noun itu menunjukkan kepada sebuah hal yang umum, ya, to a class of thing. Example, proper noun like this, Bill Smith, common noun person. Bill Smith is a person. Unicorn constructions berarti itu adalah perusahaan. Common noun adalah perusahaan. Like this, proper noun versus common noun. Nah. So proper noun are always capitalized. Yeah, remember everyone, proper noun always capitalized. Common nouns are not capitalized. Yeah. proper noun are always capitalized, common noun are not capitalized. However, sometimes it is difficult to identify whether a noun is proper or common. For example, imaginative names on and nicknames that identify a particular person, place, or thing are also considered proper, such as Big Mac, Mr. Nice Guy, and Amber Alert. Yeah. Personal names are always considered proper noun. Yeah. Jadi personal name itu always considered as proper noun. Even so, some French spelling do not capitalize the first letter of the name. Yeah. Jadi jangan ada beberapa foreigners, yeah, it's like here mereka tidak mengcapitalize, ya, tidak membuat huruf besar untuk nama depannya itu, nama pertama, nama depannya. For example, Di Nicolo, Di Angelo, Van His. Ada beberapa negara yang begitu. So when company name and personal names are involved, make sure you get the correct spelling directly from the source. Here are the some categories of proper nouns along with example. It tells of literally an article with the New York Times Moby Dick. Period of time of historical event, the Civil War, the Middle Age. Yes. Next one, proper adjective. Dia ada proper noun and ada common noun. Ini ada proper adjective. Proper adjective may be a new term to you. Yeah, mungkin ini hal baru buat kalian. But the mystery will be gone once you know the definition. Yeah, mungkin misterinya akan hilang ketika kamu tahu definisinya itu apa. A proper adjective is an adjective derived from a proper noun. Yeah, such as American, Bostonian, or Masculine. Proper adjective are always capitalized, such as proper nouns are always capitalized. Gitu. Yeah. A proper adjective is adjective derived from a proper noun. Jadi adjective, ya, adjective yang datang dari proper noun itu sendiri. Ya, seperti American, Bostonian, or Australian. Just a proper noun are always capitalized, ya. Just as proper noun, ya, sama seperti proper noun itu selalu di capitalize awal huruf awalnya. Next one, articles and prepositions. Yeah. In title of organization as well as literally an artistic work, capitalize the word the if it is the first word of the name, as in the University of Chicago. Yeah. However, if the word the is not the first word of the title, do not capitalize it. Yeah. Makanya kalau the huruf the-nya itu bukan huruf pertama di dalam apa namanya itu artikel apa itu di dalam kalimat, maka jangan kita capitalize. Kalau dia di pertama maka kita capitalize. Do not capitalize it. Also do not capitalize the following. For example, articles a and an or conjunction and but nor or of, ya. Yeah. Do not make them capitalize, yeah. Don't capitalize them. Next one, profession of three or reviewer letters, yeah. For, of, in, at, yeah. Profession of three of our letters, for, of, in, at, yeah. Conjunction and but nor, articles a and an, do not capitalize them. And the next one, first word, yeah. Ini yang biasa juga yang common ya, yang umum kita ketahui bahwasanya huruf pertama di dalam sebuah kalimat kita harus capitalize. Another category of important when it comes to capitalization is first word, ya. Such as the first word of sentence, capitalize the first word of each of following, such as. Bisa juga mengcapitalisasi the first word of each of the following. For example, sentences. Most direct questions that are complex sentence, independent question within a sentence, item displayed in a list or outline, salutation and complimentary closing. And also you can, for the personal, professional titles also you have to capitalize it. Some people capitalize every title they see. Banyakan orang ya, some people atau kadang-kadang orang itu membuat menjadi huruf besar setiap title yang mereka lihat. thinking that is the title is an official category or proper noun. However, a title is not a proper noun. Here's the general rule to follow. Capitalize title when they precede the name, but not when they are part of opposite. Do not capitalize titles when they follow the name. Yeah. Here are examples of how professional title is displayed before a name, as part of an appositive, and after a name. Yeah. So we have discussed that with the Vice President Glenn Hitzberger. Yeah. We spoke to a Vice President. Glenn Hitzberger with the problem, about the problem. We asked Glenn Hitzberger, Vice President, about the matter. Here are a few more examples. He seems director of admission will assist you. You can speak with Professor Reggie at 3 p.m. You can see over there, yeah, where the coffee festival. Next one, organizational term. Yeah, nama organisasi. Capitalize common organizational terms in your own company, such as advising department, manufacturing division, finance committee, and board of directors. Do not capitalize them these terms when they refer to department or at another organization unless you want to show special importance. Yeah. The board of directors meets at the first Friday of each month. The finance committee hasn't completed its year's budget. Hypnotitude can be capitalized in a number of ways, depending on the way that the words are at the beginning of a sentence, within a sentence, or in title or heading. Within a sentence, capitalize only the part of hypnotitude word are proper noun or proper adjective. At the beginning of sentence, capitalize the first part of the hypnotitude word and other part that are proper noun and proper adjective. You can see over here the hypnotitude word. Yeah, hypnotitude word selects email, yeah, up to date, yeah, one time. In the heading or title, capitalize all the part except article, yeah. For the short preposition and short conjunction as not professional, you can see over here within the sentence, yeah, tengah-tengah kalimat, email, yeah, up to date, yeah, one to ten. Beginning sentence, email, yeah, up to date, 1-10, yeah. Within sentence, beginning sentence, that's same. And for in heading and titles, don't forget for the preposition, don't capitalize them, yeah. For email, up to, for the word to, we cannot capitalize them. Up to date, 1-10, like this. Okay, guys. Can I have to put a share with this? Okay, guys. I think enough for today. If you have any question, you can ask me. Yeah. Do you have any question? No question. Okay. So we have to end the class for today. See you next week. Eh, kapan ininya guys? Ujiannya. UAS tanggal berapa? Anyone knows? Kapan UAS? 2 minggu lagi ya? Halo. UAS kapan everyone?
Ya Pak, di akhir bulan, Pak.
Akhir bulan tanggal 29 ya? 27-29 kalau nggak salah. I forgot. But so we have 2 meetings left ya. Yeah? 2 or 1 meeting left ya, yeah, for this month. Okay guys, I think enough for today. See you next week ya. Yeah? Thank you for joining the class. Okay, bye-bye.
Thank you.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you, sir.